wabarakatuh. My name is Ahmad Fauzan Kamil. I want can explain for experiment from the practice of social research for editions chapter 8. Introduction. Controlled experiment involve a useful background for understanding other technique which more commonly used in social science especially for explanatory purpose. Basically, the experiment involves one taking actions and two taking the consequence of that action. Topic appropriate for experiment. This experiment is more appropriate for some topic and research objective than others. Experiments are well suited for project research involve relatively limited concepts and proportions. The experimental model is very for testing hypotheses because experiment focus on determining cause and effect and are more suitable for explanatory purpose rather than for descriptive purposes. The classical experiment. In natural and social science, experiment involve three pairs of main components. First, independent of dependent, two, pretesting and post-testing, and three, experimental and control group. In this picture, the initial division of two groups is explained, namely the control group and the experimental group with randomization methods. Then between the two groups compared with the dependent variables. For the experimental group, will be given a stimulus and finally will be compared difference produced by the experimental group with a control group that does not provide stimulus. The double-blind experiment. In medical research, researchers will tend to observe improvement among patients who receive experimental drug than among those who receive placebo. Double-blind experiment eliminates this possibility because in the design, neither the subject nor the researchers know which is the experimental group and which is the control group. Selecting subject. The logic in sampling is that which involves selecting a sample that represents several populations. This consideration applies to experiment because most social researchers work in retiree institutions and universities in which laboratory research is carried out with college graduates as subject. Probability sampling. Logic and probability sampling techniques provide a method for selecting two groups that have similarities with another group. Starting with the population studied, the researchers can choose two probability samples. If each sample resembles to the total population from which they will resemble other group, the degree of similarity or representativeness exists achieved by probability sampling as a bound is a function of a sample size. Randomization. After the subject is set, the experiment can randomly assign the subject to experimental group or the control group. Researchers can complete the randomization with all subjects in series and select numbering using a random number table. Alternative, the experiment can assign odd numbers to the experimental group and even subject to the control group. Matching. Another way to achieve compatibility between the experimental and control group is drug sampling. The process of this method is similar to the quote sampling method. This process can be achieved efficient through the creation of metric quotas which are good by a relevant characteristic. Pre-experimental research design. Campbell and Stanley discussed pre-experimental design not to recommend that but because the often used in early research that is less professional, these designs are called pre-experimental to show that they do not meet scientific standards of experimental designs, and sometimes this can be used because the conditions for full experiment are not possible. Experimental research designs. The first design, the one suit case study. Second, one group pretest post-test design. Third, static group comparison. Validity issue in experimental research. First, history. Two, masturbation, t-testing. Four, instrumentation. 5. Substical regressions. 6. Selection bias. 7. Experimental mortality. And 8. Demonization. Set of external invalidity. Internal invalidity is only as a complication that will be faced by researchers. Besides, the internal invalidity is related to the generalization of experimental findings to the real world. generalization of experimental findings will be treated as the author saw if there an interaction between the testing situation and the experimental stimulus. Alternative experimental setting. First, factorial designs. 2, web-based experiment, and 3, natural experiment. Strength and weakness of the experimental method. Experiments are the main tool for studying relationship as a result. However, like all research methods, experiments have strengths and weaknesses. The main advantage of the control experiments lies in isolating the impact of experimental variable over time. This is evident in terms of the basic experimental model, and the biggest weakness of the laboratory experiment lies in falsity, social process, and the occur in laboratory setting may not always occur in social setting that are not natural. Ethics and experiments. First, experiment almost always involve, in most cases, explaining the purpose of the experiment to the subject may cause them to behave different. Trying to appear less likely to be prejudiced because it is important to determine. Second, experiments are usually annoying. Subjects are often placed in unusual situations and are asked to experiment unusual experiment even when the subject is not physically injured. 2. Qualitative field research. Introduction. Field research involves the direct observation of social phenomena in their natural setting. Typically, field research is qualitative rather than quantitative. In field research, observation, data processing, and analysis are interwoven cyclical process. Topics appropriate to field research. Field research is specifically appropriate for topics and processes that are not easily quantifiable. They are best studied in natural setting, or they change over time. Among these topics are practice, episodes, encounter, roles, relationship, groups, organization, settlement, social work, and lifestyles or subcultures. Special consideration in qualitative field research. Among the special considerations involved in field research are the various possible roles of the observers and the researchers' relationship with the subject.
Special consideration in qualitative field research. Among the special considerations involved in field research are the various possible roles of the observer and the researcher relationship with the subject.
Some qualitative field research paradigms. Field research can be guided by any one of several paradigms, such as naturalism, ethnomethodology, grounded theory, case study, and the extended case method, institutional ethnography, and participatory action research.
Ethics and qualitative field research. All forms of social research raise ethical issues by bringing researchers into direct and often intimate contact with their subject. Field research raises ethical issues in very dramatic ways. Here are some of the problems mentioned by John and Lynn Lovett. Is it ethical to talk to people when they don't know you are going to record their words? 2. Is it ethical to get information for all needs from people you hate? Is it ethical to see a severe need for assistance and not respond to it directly? Is it ethical to be in a situation or situation but not wholeheartedly committed to it? Is it ethical to develop a calculated attitude towards other human beings that is be strategic in your relationship? Is it ethical to take sides or avoid taking sides in the fight situation? Is it ethical to pay people exchange for access to their lives and thoughts? Is it ethical to use people as allies or informants to get permission to enter others or to lose understanding observation of participation carries special ethical concerns. You must respect someone's confidentiality.
Hello, my name is Nadia Tulmuflihah. My present number 26. Content analysis, as I mentioned in the chapter introduction, content analysis is the study of recorded human communication. Among the forms suitable for study are books, magazines, web pages, poems, newspaper, song, paintings, speeches, letters, email messages, bulletin board posting on the internet, laws and constitution, as well as any components for collection theory. Analyzing existing statistics, frequently you can or must undertake social science inquiry through the use of official or quasi-official statistics. This differs from secondary analysis, in which you obtain a copy of someone else's data and undertake your own statistical analysis. In this section, we are going to look at ways of using the data analysis that others have already done. Comparative and historical research. Social scientists use comparative and historical methods to discover patterns in the history of different cultures. Intrusive on research, social media and other online activities have opened up a new realm of possibilities for intrusive research, ethics and intrusive measures. Sometimes even intrusive measures can raise the possibility of violating subjects' privacy. The general principle of honest observation analysis and reporting of apply to our research techniques.
Hello, my name is Prisciliana Kupelgiani. I will explain about the research evaluation. Evaluation research is the process of determining whether social interventions have produced the desired result or not. This evaluation is used to study, assess, and help improve social programs in all important aspects. Then, I will explain to you about topics appropriate for evaluation research. Appropriate topics in evaluation research, namely, needs assessment studies that aim to determine the presence and level of problems, like population segments, like parents. Cost-benefit studies that determine whether the result of a program can be justified by the cost, but financially and otherwise. Monitoring studies that provide a steady flow of information about something interesting, program evaluation or outcome assessment determine whether social intervention produce the desired result, like crime or epidemics. And then, in preparing for the evaluation, the researcher must pay attention to the measurement problems. Let's take a closer look at the types of measurement that evaluation research must take, including 1. Specifying outcomes. As I suggest, the key variable to be evaluated by the evaluation research is the result, or what is called the response variable. 2. Measuring experimental context. Measuring the dependent variable directly involved in the experimental program is only the beginning. 3. Specifying intervention. In addition to making measurements that are relevant to the result of a program. 4. Specifying the population in evaluation and intervention, it is important to determine the population of possible subjects four of whom the program is suitable. 5. New versus existing measure. In providing measurement of these various types of variable, research must continue to choose whether to make new action or use those already designed by others. And 6. Operationalizing success or failure. One of most tiring aspects of evaluation research is determine whether the program being reviewed is successful or fails. And this is a type of evaluation research design. Research is organized, observations are made and recorded, and mass data is accumulated for analysis. 1. Experimental design. 2. Quasi-experimental designs. And 3. Qualitative evaluation. Evaluation of research itself is not a method, but rather an application of social research methods. As such, it can involve one of several research designs. Here are three main types of research design that are suitable for evaluation. In the case of evaluation research, we need to develop more specific measure of importance. And then the social context, logistical problems, and use of research results. In context, logistical problems refer to moving supplies, and use of research results, like facts from evaluation research, concern how evaluation is used, because the purpose of evaluation research is to determine the success or failure of social intervention. And then social indicator research, directly development file in social research involves the development and monitoring of social indicators aggregate statistics that reflect the social or social condition of society, the death penalty and deterrence. Research is being devoted to finding relationship between variables in the whole society. Computer simulation. Social indicators are located in the file of computer simulation. And ethics and evaluation research. Sometimes the social intervention being assessed in evaluation research themselves raise ethical issues. Evaluation research may entail added pressure to produce specific results as desired by interested parties. Fraudulent research is an evaluation study can have several consequences produced by other types of research. The FN evaluation research is basically related to real world problems. Sometimes social intervention are evaluated raising ethical issues. That evaluation research is sometimes part of the process that wants to be evaluated and can have unintended consequence. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Rebi Salsabila and my present number is 39. And I would like to explain about qualitative methods. Qualitative methods demonstrate a different approach to scholarly inquiry than methods of quantitative research, although the process are similar. Qualitative methods rely on text and image data, have a unique step in data analysis, and draw on diverse design. There are several characteristics of qualitative research. First is natural setting, and then researcher as a key instrument, multiple source of data, and then inductive and deductive data analysis, participant meanings, emergent designs, reflexivity, and then holistic account. Qualitative design. This approach has emerged in the field of qualitative research since it has matured in the social science since the early 1990s. They include procedure for data collection, analysis, and writing, but they originated out of discipline in social science. The researcher's role and reflexivity. The reflexivity requires commenting on two important points. The first one is past experience, and the second one is how past experience shape interpretation. Data collection procedure. There are procedures for collecting data. First is a qualitative observation is when the researchers take field notes on the behavior and activities of individual at the research site. In qualitative interviews, the researcher conducts face-to-face interview with the participant, telephone interview, or engage in focus group interviews with 6 to 8 interviews in each group. And then, during the process of research, the investigator may collect qualitative documents, and then qualitative audiovisual and digital material, that including social media materials. And the last one, in a discussion about the data collection form. And then data recording procedures. They have a two of procedure data recording. First one is observation protocol, and second one is interview protocol. Data analysis procedure. Simultaneous procedure, winnowing the data, using qualitative computer software programs for assistance, overview of the data analysis process, and then specific coding procedure on using predetermined coding on and coding visual image for the data analysis by type of approach. And then interpretation. Interpretation in qualitative research involves several procedures, summarizing the overall findings, comparing the findings to the literature, discussing a personal view of findings, stating limitation and future research. Validity and reliability. Quantitative validity means that the researchers checks for the accuracy of the finding by employing certain procedures. And whereas qualitative reliability indicates that the researchers' approach is consistent across different researchers and among different projects. Writing the qualitative report. A plan for qualitative methods should end with some comments about the narrative that will emerge from the data analysis. Numerous varieties of narratives exist, and examples from scholarly journals illustrate these models. The qualitative research paradigm. The first is the ethnographic research design. This design emerged from the field of anthropology, primarily from the contribution of Bronislaw Malinowski, Robert Park, and Franz Boas. The ethnographic study includes in-depth interviewing and continual and ongoing participant observation of a situation. The researcher's role. The role of researchers as the primary data collection instrument necessitate the identification of personal values, assumptions, and bias at the outset of the study. To the bonding the study, there are setting, actors, event, and process.
Next chapter is about mixed method procedure. Definition of mixed method, according to Jensen, Onguzi, and Turner, collecting qualitative and quantitative data to answer research question or hypothesis, includes two methods such as data collection, data analysis from the data, the form of data are integrated in design analysis through the merging of data and building from one database to another. The procedure is often informed by a philosophy of worldview and theory. There are four types of mixed method design. First, convergent mixed method design. Second, exploratory sequential mixed method design. Third, exploratory sequential mixed method design. And the last is several complex mixed method design. Convergent mixed method design. In this single-based approach, the researcher collects both quantitative and qualitative data, analyze them separately, and then compare the results to see if the findings confirm or disconfirm each other. And then exploratory sequential mixed method design. This approach involves a two-phase data collection project in which the researcher collects quantitative data in the first phase, analyze the result, and then use the result to plan the second qualitative phase. And then exploratory sequential mixed data design. This approach is the opposite of sequential explanatory. The researcher first begins by exploring the quantitative data and analyze, then build